awesome animals.
Hello, everyone. Today we will be traveling to Southern Europe and we will be talking about the Maltese dog breed. Please don't forget to smash that like button and subscribe to our channel for future weekly videos. The Maltese is an ancient breed, one of several small bichon dogs found around the Mediterranean for thousands of years. His exact place of origin is a mystery, with conjecture including Sicily, Egypt, and Southern Europe, but most historians pinpoint Malta for the development of the breed. The dogs may have been bartered for food and used to help protect their ship's food rations from rodents. On Malta, these dogs were bred entirely as companions and comforters, being especially favored by the ladies, who often carried them in their sleeves or held them in their laps when in their carriages taking air. The Maltese is gentle, affectionate, intelligent, responsive, and trusting. A good family dog, Maltese are lively, playful, vigorous, and they generally enjoy learning tricks. They can be snappy with raucous children. Maltese dogs only grow to around 7 to 12 inches in height and weigh about 4 to 8 pounds. Maltese are susceptible to bacterial and viral infections, the same ones that all dogs can get, such as parvo, rabies, and distemper. Many of these infections are preventable through vaccination, which your vet will recommend. Unlike some breeds, the Maltese probably does come from its namesake Malta. They were bred down from a Spitz-like dog that was native to the area and was used for hunting rodents. Some suggest the little dogs actually have a pawhold in Asia, but evidence is murky. The history of the Maltese has been difficult to tease out, as the terms were often used as catch-all for several breed of toy dogs. Many historical references to Maltese dogs, it turns out, were actually descriptions of Pomeranians. These lap dogs were a hit among royalty. Queens especially would cherish these pooches, feeding them out of gold dishes. The dog's likeness has been found on ceramics and other pieces of artwork in Egypt and in Greece, where owners would construct elaborate tombs for their deceased canines. Publius, the governor of Rome in the 1st century, had a little Maltese named Isa that was endlessly spoiled. Her likeness was captured in a painting and the poet Martial wrote a poem praising her beauty. Queen Elizabeth I and Mary Queen of Scots both had and adored their little Maltese pups. More recently, the dogs have become a favorite with Hollywood royalty. Famous fans include Halle Berry and Elizabeth Taylor. At Emerald Coast Children's Advocacy Center in Florida, Riley the Maltese is helping people every day. He has been working as a therapy dog since 2009, participating in more than 400 therapy sessions. Dogs like Riley are a wonderful help at nursing homes, hospitals, disaster areas, and unprivileged schools. Petting an animal can reduce stress, encourage empathy, and decrease bullying, just to name a few of the many ways dogs can make our days brighter. Maltese make great therapy dogs because they're loving and small, which means they can cuddle right up to whomever they're trying to help. The wealthiest Maltese pooch is named Trouble. He was the much-loved first child of billionaire New York City hotelier Leona Helmsley, aka the Queen of Mean. And when she died back in 2007, she bequeathed an estimated $12 million of her fortune to the care and comfort of wee Trouble. The Maltese is the oldest of the toy breeds from Europe. According to the American Kennel Club, Egyptian artifacts of Maltese dogs have been found, which means ancient Egyptians may have worshipped the breed. Greek poetry, dating from 5 AD, shows images of small, long-haired dogs like the Maltese. And according to the 18th century religious scholar Corallus Maria Duville, ancient Greek writings by historians like Strabo mention small, pretty dogs known as catelli. They're extremely alert and can spring into action if they perceive a threat to their humans. But it's important to train your Maltese not to be overprotective, because they can have a tendency to bark excessively and even bite someone they think is a danger.
If you've enjoyed this video, please smash that like button and subscribe to our channel for future weekly videos. See you guys next time. Goodbye!